Scientists around the world right now are studying how the coronavirus could be spreading. The latest study is looking into how exactly it's spreading through the air. Fox 5's Misha DeBono was live for us at Scripps Hospital in Encinitas with the warning. Misha.
Yeah, Andrew, good evening. Of course, we know that the virus spreads through the air. That's why we're wearing our masks and social distancing. But now these scientists are confirming that it's not just the regular droplets from, say, a cough or a sneeze, but it's actually these microscopic particles that go even faster and farther through the air that is particularly dangerous, especially if you're going to be indoors. And in fact, they're saying that might actually explain the surge that we're seeing partially right now.
What these scientists are saying is there's accumulating evidence that aerosols, these tiny particles that hang in the air, they can be another source of potential infection.
A group of 239 health experts from around the world are sounding the alarm over new evidence that finds the tiniest droplets from your mouth or nose can linger in the air for longer periods of time and travel farther and plant more deeply in the lungs. Daniel Oren is with Scripps Research.
The evidence mainly is coming from two sources. We've seen a couple of super spreading events, cases where people were too far apart really to be in range of these regular droplets that come out of people's mouths.
In one case in Washington State, a 60-member choir were practicing at a safe distance apart. 45 of them became infected with coronavirus.
The only way that could happen is through probably this aerosol transmission. Just to give you some sense, aerosol means that it's smaller than 5 microns. Now that's about, you have to take about 20 of these and stick them together to make the thickness of one human hair. So these are really tiny particles.
He provided us with this simulation video of one cough created to show how quickly micro droplets spread and linger through a room the size of an average classroom with just 10 people.
You know, increasingly, people outside the World Health Organization, you know, we're coming to the consensus that being inside is especially dangerous. That's why we're seeing these cases, these super spreading events. So the advice to go outside, to keep your distance, is more important than ever.
And of course, wearing your mask, especially if you're going to be indoors and with people not in your immediate family that you've been, say, in lockdown with for all of these months. He also says that, you know, timing really matters. So if you are going to the store, if you're somewhere, anywhere indoors for 15 minutes, that's fine. If you're going to be in front of somebody for over an hour, that's when you're really putting yourself at risk. So just more good information for all of us to have.